In one slash, Yasha mercilessly splits Asura in two. Asura finds himself back in Naraka, burning with more rage than ever. But for now, his only option is to follow the light.
Just as they are, you know. If you can accept their actions, perhaps you should let go and allow your soul to become one with Gaia. You choose to move forward? This is exactly why your soul will never belong to the Goma, nor the Seven Deities. There is a great power hidden in you, one I have been looking for. So, Deus is to bring salvation to Gaia. But it seems he cannot do it without your daughter's power.
Mithra.
Now, remember why you are here in the first place. It will spur you on, my boy. Fuel the fire!
Ah! Control yourself!
Immersing oneself in battle like that. Well done, Asura!
Now that you have something to protect, why are you so full of rage? Or perhaps that is exactly why.
Something to protect? Nonsense! The only reason one needs to fight is the fight itself!
That is so like you, Master. We have cleared this area of Goma. Let us return to Shinkoku.
Right.
Mithra, your father has returned. Welcome home, dear.
Thanks.
So, that is what he must protect?
Yes, though you may not understand why. Durga.
Brother?
He almost looks scared of her.
He just doesn't know what to do when she starts crying.
Then he should pacify her.
Him?
Move!
Not bad, Asura. That uncontrollable rage of yours suits you well. See what I mean?
Asura, join us! Should we work together, we could more effectively exterminate the Goma!
Don't test me!
You are aware Mithra is the only suitable vessel to become priestess. Raise her with care, incompetent as you may be.
I wager that is one of your more charming features. At least we know now the source of the flame that burns in your soul. In other words, you...
Stop.
What was that?
He
even one of the 8 Guardian Generals is no match for his own daughter, is he?
She's so small.
Do you know what I think? I believe that you only wish the best for our daughter.
Shala Atramana.